If you really want to get deeply into the woods, pay attention to who's running for lieutenant governor. Because let's play out this potential scenario. Dianne Feinstein gets reelected, most likely. She goes on about a year and says, I don't want to be senator anymore. I don't want to resign. This is a very strong current that's going on within the upper circles of the Democratic Party right now. She did not want to run for re-election this year. She was urged to run for re-election by the Democratic leadership in Washington because they did not want an expensive primary battle in California that would suck money out of the places they want to spend it to try to take control of the Senate in other states. So they said, Dianne, you run. Run again. And you'll be cakewalk. It won't cost anything. And then, of course, John De Leon jumps into the thing. So now there is going to be a race. It's going to be probably an expensive race. So let's say down the line, in a year or two, Dianne Feinstein, a couple of years, Dianne Feinstein, I really don't want to be a senator anymore. She has health problems, her husband has health problems. One thing or another, the Democrats don't take control of the Senate. That's another factor in the whole thing. Then she resigns. Then who would the next governor appoint? Well, if the next governor is Gavin Newsom, you might say, maybe I'd like to be a U.S. senator because I'd like to be President of the United States. And that's a better place to run for President of the United States. And therefore, he appoints himself a lieutenant governor, then becomes the governor of California. So you better pay attention to who's running for lieutenant governor as well.